If you want to jump to a certain spot in the video and you're not sure where it is, you can click on these three little dots beneath a video and go to show transcript. And this will give you the entire transcript, the entire video, whether they have captions or you're just looking at the auto-generated ones here. In the browser, hit Command F to find, where did I talk about the pivot? Oh, here it is. It's 7:59. Here's the big pivot. It's going to be happening. And click right there and it goes straight to that point in the video. You can do the same thing on mobile, but instead you're going to hit on the down arrow next to the video title, get to the description. At the bottom, you see show transcript. And here you can see the transcript going while you play. You can't search it, but you can certainly scroll through it, find the parts you want, and tap right there and skip to that part of the video as well. If you're watching your favorite music video and you want it to keep looping, right click anywhere on desktop. You have this loop option right here. And now it'll keep playing over and over and over again. On mobile, you can do the same thing. You just tap on the video up these three little dots upper right corner. Tap on those, and here is loop video off, and now loop video is on. YouTube actually syncs your viewing across multiple devices, but if you're watching on your phone and then go to your desktop, you'll see in the bottom right corner that a mini player shows up, and now you can start watching that video on desktop that you were watching on your phone, so you can pick up right where you left off. This is pretty cool. If you just long press on the video, you can slide your finger back and forth across the screen to go straight to the point in that video that you want. But even cooler is while it's playing, if you double tap with two fingers on the right side, it'll go to the next chapter. Or double tap on the left side, it goes back previous to the beginning of the chapter before. Of course, you can always double tap with one finger and it'll just skip forward 10 seconds. Or double tap with one finger on the left side and it goes back by 10 seconds. It is so easy to keep scrolling on YouTube and waste a lot of time. Thankfully, in the upper right corner, if you click on your icon, you now have this option for time watch right here in the middle. If you click on it, it will show you how much time you're spending on YouTube, as well as reminders to take a break and remind you it's bedtime, or just autoplay if you just want to kill even more time. If you really want to get nerdy on all the video encoding and streaming that's going on in a video anywhere on desktop, you can right click and go to Stats for Nerds, and here you'll see everything that's going on about your connection speed, network activity, buffer health, codecs, frames, and everything. You can do it on mobile as well, but you'll need to first go up to your icon in the upper right corner and then go to Settings, and then in here tap on General. And in General, you got lots of really cool options in here if you want to like skip forward more than 10 seconds or less than 10 seconds at a time. But go down here to Stats for Nerd, toggle that on, then go back out to the video you want to look at, and then here under these three little dots upper right corner, tap it. Now it's down here at the bottom, Stats for Nerds, and you can now see it on mobile as well. Perhaps you want to search for something and spend some time researching how to do something, but you don't want all of that browsing history to mess up your recommendations on your homepage and suggested videos. Well, instead, you can go to File, Open Incognito Window, and here you can browse YouTube to your heart's content without it messing up anything in your recommendations. Thankfully, this also works on mobile. In the upper right corner, just tap on your icon, and here you'll see Turn on Incognito. If you tap it, it'll now be in incognito mode. You can go through and browse YouTube without it impacting your recommendations or your search history or anything. When you're done, just come up back up here to incognito and select turn it off, and you'll be right back into your account. Now, speaking of recommendations, if you're getting a little bit bored of everything that YouTube is suggesting to you and you want to just try something new and fresh, go up and click on this new to you chip at the top of YouTube, and it will completely give you new recommendations of channels you haven't watched before, videos that you haven't seen, just give you a whole new experience of things that you can dive into. And yes, it works on mobile too. All these chips at the top, it'll either be the very last one if you haven't used it before, or it'll be right here at the very beginning. If you've used it recently, just tap it here on mobile and get a whole set of new recommendations once again. You're watching YouTube, you find this great video and you want to share it, but you want to share it starting at like this point right here to someone. What you can easily do is go down here, click on the share, and then here's this little check mark right here. Start it at 250 or whatever time you want to type in here, and then click this copy link. And when someone then goes and enters in that URL, it'll start playing that video right at that exact time. But unfortunately, on mobile, that is not the case. If I tap on share, I can only copy the link. If you pay the monthly fee for YouTube Premium, you will have this download button below the video. You can click on download and it'll download the video to your computer, which is great because now you can watch it when you're offline, if you're in an airplane or you're in a subway or a place where you don't have really great access. And now you can either click here to view or you can go up here and go to downloads, and it downloads all the videos you've downloaded. It'll be right here. And under download settings, you can adjust the quality, whether you want it to be high quality or low quality. The higher the quality, the more disk space it takes up. And then when you're done with all of them, you can just click all, delete all downloads right here, and that frees up all your space. On mobile, it works a little bit different. On the home page, while you're scrolling, you can either tap on these three little dots right underneath the video and click download there. Or if you're actually watching the video, you see download icon right here as well. You could tap it and it'll start downloading. Now to find and access these downloaded videos, you have to go back to the home page. You see down here in the bottom right corner, it says library. If you tap on your library, you have this option right here in the middle called downloads. Now this is gives you a little bit of a different feature because now you have your downloads here at the top that you can come watch and play at any time, but they also give you recommended downloads, or you can do smart downloads, which is when you're on Wi-Fi, we'll download 20 recommended videos and refresh them weekly. Then you'll always have something to watch offline on your phone. This is my favorite, to use keyboard shortcuts. I use these all the time to browse YouTube. You can find all these keyboard shortcuts easily by hitting shift and question mark on your keyboard, and you'll see all of them right here, but I'll show you my favorite ones real quick on desktop and then on mobile. On desktop, you can click the icon and change the playback speed here if you want, but on your keyboard, it is just shift greater than or less than to speed up or slow down the speed. And of course, to pause, it's K. To skip forward 10 seconds, it is L. And to go back 10 seconds at a time, it is J. On mobile, they've simplified this a lot. If you are a YouTube Premium subscriber, you can go to the upper three dots and go to listening controls in here. Now you can skip forward from video to video if you'd like, or you can skip forward 10 seconds, last, you know, back 10 seconds, or adjust the speed as you want all up from one spot, which is great if you listen to a lot of podcasts on YouTube especially. Now to be clear, you still can use these controls if you're not a premium member. You just gotta click these three little dots up here, and instead of going to listening controls, you go to playback speed here and you can change it there. And then of course you can just double tap or triple tap or whatever you wanna do to skip forward and backwards. It's all right there, you know, just not all in one easy navigation screen.
As a YouTube strategist who has worked with over 1,000 creators and brands on this platform, I know a lot of these tools, a lot of these tips have absolutely increased and enhanced my quality of life here on this platform, and know they will for you too. Thanks to Gizmodo for assembling a lot of these tips together. Link to them down below. And if you are someone who's trying to grow your channel, you want more views, you want more subscribers, you want to grow the business that you're developing here online, then these are the next videos for you to watch. These will be the next videos you need to get into. How do I get more views, more subscribers, and grow my business on YouTube? Click right here, and I'll see you over in those next videos.